Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Molly Malone's Irish Bar and music venue in the heart of Los Angeles. Thank you. I'd like to extend a warm welcome to our audience here this evening, and especially to the people of Salcombe and the members of the Lifeboat Station and all the curators of the William and Emma Heritage and Centenary events. We're ready to begin our musical tribute, inspired by the events of October the 27th, 1916, in Salcombe, England. So let me introduce to you our narrator for this evening's performance, our dear friend, Lionel Conway.
In October 1916, Britain had been at war with Germany for 2 years. The First World War of 1914 had started out as a glorious campaign, but by 1916, the horrors of trench warfare and the significant casualties cast a dark cloud over the citizens of Britain. In the towns and villages, people lived with the fear and pain of seeing their local men join the war and did their best to maintain their everyday lives. But for one such town, in a quiet corner of the southwest of England, a tragedy involving an unprecedented loss of life was about to unfold in the very heart of their community. So let us take you back 100 years to the very early hours of October 27th, 1916, in the seaside town of Salcombe, Devon.
The Royal National Lifeboat Institute began in 1824 and is one of Britain's most important charitable organisations. These days it operates 340 lifeboats. The lifeboat in Salcombe in 1916 was called the William and Emma. She was built for a crew of 15 men and was fitted with 12 oars and 3 sails. The crew were all volunteers, with a majority drawn from the town's fishing fleet. Due to the war, most of the men were aged over 40. The crew were a tight-knit group of men, with 2 sets of brothers and a father, his 2 sons, all on board on October the 27th. The coxswain was one of the town's most experienced and respected skippers, Sam Distin, who knew how to put the boat and the crew through its paces.
Look alive there, boys, and trim those sails. Stow the ballast tight, all hands to the gunwales. There's a southerly blowing hard 4 or 5. Let's get awash and be sure to catch the tide.
To the
During the course of the First World War, over 6 million men were mobilized in the British Isles, and over 700,000 men were killed. Voluntary enlistment was soon replaced by conscription for men aged between 18 and 41. The men of Salcombe joined the Royal Navy, Merchant Navy, and the Army. Leaving the town for service was always very emotional, for every man knew the risks of going to war.
Time down Island Street to say farewell to the folks and meet. Harbor view from off the fort. There's no other place like this, I'm sure. When I'm feeling down and blue, I'll close my eyes and think of you, and I'll always be here in Salcombe by the sea. Yes, I'll always be here in Salcombe by the sea.
A southerly gale force wind and heavy seas greeted the early hours of October the 27th off the coast of Salcombe. Around 5 a.m., the schooner, Western Last, foundered on Langeston Point, and sent out a distress signal. A signal to launch the lifeboat was in turn relayed to Salcombe, and despite delays due to damaged phone lines, William and Emma was launched just after 7 o'clock. What the crew of the lifeboat did not know was that in the meantime, the crew of the Western Lass had been rescued from the land by local volunteers in the area. So William and Emma set out into the 50-mile-per-hour winds and heavy seas, breaking over the sandbar that stretches across the harbour mouth. They managed to navigate out to the Western Lass and soon realised the crew had been rescued. Turning for home, the crew faced the perilous task of recrossing the huge waves breaking in the area of the bar. They would not make it. The boat was pitched over by a huge freak wave and all 15 men were thrown into the treacherous sea.
We'll be right back.
In the raging seas, the brave crew fought to reach the shore. It was an impossible task. Townsfolk watched in horror as the men conceded in the waves. 13 of the crew were drowned. By some miracle, 2 of the crew, Edwin Distin and William Johnson, survived. We will now perform The Sea, a song that imagines the last moments of one of the crew, the requiem, an angel on my shoulder, a tribute from a mourning wife to her lost husband.
Can you hear me? I fear I can't hold on to live the life we've made, to see my newborn son. I'm drifting all alone. I see the angels high above. My soul is going home. Remember me, my love. Let me drown in this raging sea. Let go my hands. Cast me free. I'm no more the land. This is my destiny. I'm forevermore the sea. This life's been one too beautiful to measure. Kiss beyond my dreams, moments to be treasured. So hold me one more time. As I know I'm fading fast, press me close against your heart, for this day will be my last. I saw the sky turn red and the sea turn black, and with one last breath there's no turning back. I saw the stars dissolve, the moon eclipsed the sun. On this boat that speeds me to Elysium. And this boat that speeds me to Elysium. Forevermore, the sea. and forevermore. The sea, the sea.
The community of Salcombe and the RNLI was in shock and mourning for their loss. The entire nation joined them in their grief. Despite the daily bad news from the front, this tragedy hit a chord with the British people. But in true British character and spirit, the townspeople of Salcombe picked themselves up and moved forward. The Great War was to last another two more years. A new lifeboat was commissioned in Salcombe in 1917. One of the survivors, Eddie Distin, agreed to be the coxswain, and a new crew of volunteers were recruited. Life would go on, and finally the men at war would return to their beloved homes.
One, two.
Sunset and the evening star, there'll be no morning of the bar. One click call you'll hear from me when I put my soul out to sea.
We're on our way back home.
We're all born in time and place. Must meet our pilot face to face. We're on our way, we're on our way back home. We rode the boat, we rode the boat. We're on our way, we're on our way back home. We rode the boat. Sadness of farewell.
We're on our way back home.
The moon is up, the earth's asleep, the lights are smiling across the deep.
We're on our way back home.
Tides of life may push us far. So hold me tight, let's cross the bar.
We're on our way.
The courage and sacrifice of the 13 crewmen who lost their lives would never be forgotten. In 1921, a memorial dedicated to the local men who had fallen in the war and the crew of the William and Emma was unveiled in the heart of Salcombe, overlooking the harbour. A fitting tribute to an extraordinary tragedy and the spirit of the men who served and sacrificed their lives to help those in peril on the sea.
One more time down Island Street to say farewell to the folks and meet. Harbour view from off the fore. There's no other place like this, I'm sure. When I'm feeling down and blue, I'll close my eyes and think of you, and I'll always be here in Salcombe by the sea. Yes, I'll always be Salcombe by the sea.